Viva la raza! We lie, we cheat, we steal. Hey, it's... No, we don't do that around here. We don't do that around here. It's just jokes, Brad. It's just jokes. It's not a thing. What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we have a brand new WWE action figure car for you guys. Now, I don't know if you guys can see this thing, but it's pretty damn massive, okay? It's pretty damn massive. It's epic. It's actually really damn cool. I've seen a lot of people use this. My boy MBG, my boy Hero Figs, as we had a little fun with in the beginning there. I think my boy G-Natty has this car. There's a lot of people that have owned this car before, man. And there's a lot of people that own this car, and it's great for your WWE figures, and I'm going to showcase it here today, and I also have a brand new MDT figure attire that I want to show you. Of course, you guys saw this one come to fruition. I have a brand new one that I want to unveil to you guys, and you guys will see that in the coming weeks or days or whatever the hell here. But today, guys, we do have this brand new car. I also want to do a comparison with the Wreckin' Slammobile and why this one may be better for you or whatever, but as you guys can see, we do have Eddie Guerrero chilling in the front right here. This is the Legend Series Eddie Guerrero. I put the WWE Championship on there because it looks so freaking good. God, that's just excellent. Anyways, there's the Eddie Guerrero. Here is the full car. Now, this is not something that you're going to find at Walmart. I don't know when this released. Maybe I can get like a damn year on the bottom of this thing. Yeah, that's what I freaking thought. I think, unless this is like when Brat started, it says 2002 on the bottom. Now, I was going to guess 2003. That was going to be my guess. It may have came out in 2002. I'm not exactly sure if that's, you know, when Brat started or when, you know, I don't know. I don't know if that's when this car was released or if that's when the company or whatever, the little brand of dolls actually came out. But this car, I remember seeing this in stores when I was a kid. However, I don't know if they've done re-releases. I'm not sure what the case is, but you can't find this in stores, I don't think. You can, however, find it on eBay. You can find it on Mercari, which is a really good selling app for WWE figures. I still have yet to do my online toy hunt before. I want to do an online toy hunt where we go through different websites and I show you guys how I find good figure deals and stuff like that when shopping online. But here is the car, and it is actually very insane. It's very big. It's kind of hard to capture everything on camera. I'm going to try and move this back. Here is the Eddie Guerrero, and you guys can just kind of see how big that is compared to the Eddie Guerrero. I mean, it is a very big vehicle. It is massive, and I even have the Wreckin' Slam Cycle over here that we can also compare it to. So if we compare it to the Wreckin' Slam Cycle, it's probably not even going to fit on camera. That's how damn big it is. But here is a little side by side. You guys can see the front of the Wreckin' Slam Cycle comes up to about right behind. Hey guys, this is actually editing tray, and I just noticed that I called it Wreckin' Slam Cycle like 10 times, so just ignore my dumb ass and continue with the video. The front wheel. So you definitely get a lot more size out of it. I mean, it would not fit as precise into an arena as the Wreckin' Slam Cycle would. And depending on the deal, I don't know how much you can get this for. I've seen it go for like 100. I've seen it go for 50. I've seen it go for like 35. I got an actual amazing deal on mine. My boy Burnout Inc., Chase. If you guys don't know Chase from Burnout Inc., he sent me a hellacious deal on this. He said, bro, you gotta get this deal. I had to send it to you. He's also one of those guys that actually owns this vehicle, but he sent me the deal. I immediately purchased it, and the thing arrived like literally a day and a half later. It was the quickest shipping I've ever seen in my entire damn life, but this thing does also have operational doors. You guys can see it has side mirrors on it. It's got the front windshield on there, as cars do. It is a convertible, as you guys can see, but it's a perfect lowrider. Like, you can do a lot of stuff with this. You can do, you know, insane entrances. You can do like some cool photography. I've seen squared circle photography. MBG, a lot of guys have done that, but you can open this up. You get operational steering wheel in here. I think the motor was supposed to work. Now, this is actually insane. I don't know if you guys can see this right here, but the gear shift actually moves like a real gear shift, which is kind of insane. Like, that's a pretty good detail right there. Now, I think I don't know for sure, but I could have sworn that, yeah, look at that. The damn glove box opens up, bro. The glove box opens up. So the glove box opens. You get the good stuff. You even have operational seat belts in there. You get your operational seat belts in there that actually plug in. Now, the Bratz dolls were huge, I will say. Like, they were absolutely massive. They had big heads. Like, they were kind of crazy, but I remember my cousin always getting them at Christmas. I don't know if she ever got this car. I want to say she she's had this car before. On the back it says Bratz. You get some nice chrome wheelage going on. I like the little sky blue color we're going on. It's kind of, you know, it's not exactly feminine. It's not masculine. It's perfect down the line. You know, if you know, they're not crossing the line here with the color. I think it's pretty nice and bright and looks good and everything. Pretty neutral going on. I don't know if the hood opens up. I don't think the hood opens up. However, the trunk is operational. So you can push this button, raise that up, put a dead body in there. You can put all kinds of crazy stuff in there. You get the back fenders. The battery pack is right there, which I think is broken or like the screws missing or something. But you can put a lot of ish back here. Do we have a chair? Let's see if we can fit this body back here. I think if we wanted to, we could probably make this body fit back here. So if you had somebody right there, then you just... Okay, so yeah, it does fit. That's absolutely excellent. So yeah, you could fit a body in there for a WWE figure. Now, I don't think anything outside the standard Seth Rollins, Finn Balor body would fit, but this is a really cool piece. I am really enjoying the playability that we got out of this. Now, you know, we're always expanding the MDT parking lot garage because, you know, anything... With this Extreme Division and all these crazy things going on a weekly basis on MDT television, I say weekly, I guess I should say episodic basis, when the things actually come out, that is when the craziness takes place. But you get all this great stuff, and to be almost 20 years old, which makes me want to vomit, if this actually released in 2002, this is a really damn good piece. There's like a minor scratch right here. I mean, I could custom paint it like the truck if I wanted to. This thing will definitely see TV time when it comes time to, you know, for the new episode to drop. I don't know if it'll be on the next episode, but you know what I'm saying. When the new episodes do drop, or a pay-per-view or whatever, we will get usage out of this in some freaking way. I mean, that's just the bottom line. But back here in the back, I think you can also put... I don't think you could put a table. I mean, we could try a table. I don't know if a table will fit back here. Yeah, I don't think you're going to get that much out of it, but you could probably fit a chair. Can I get a goddamn chair? You can put the Money in the Bank briefcase back there. That'll shut in there. That's pretty good. Okay, I finally found a chair. For the love of Christ, I need an assistant. An assistant to hand me chairs. There you go. So you can fit some weaponry back in there. That's always beautiful to see. But yes, I definitely wanted to get on here and showcase this. But not only did I want to showcase the car, which is just a beautiful specimen piece, they also make other things. They made like a tour bus or something that I'm also trying to track down. And they made a damn limo that I also picked up that's on the way. So I'll do a video on the limo if you guys want to see the limo and we can do a comparison and stuff. But yeah, I want to say the headlights are operational as well. I don't know. Let's move the hell on. Moving on to the MDT attire, guys. So you guys know this was the standard first version, right? We got my black sleeve. You got the pink MDT attire. You guys have seen this one, right? You guys saw the figure. All right, well, this is a new attire that I worked on, and it is MDT Live inspired. So we got a guy, you know, we kind of got the same kind of gear going on, except the tights are in black. You get some pink accents. Now, I thought about going pink sleeve, pink wrist tape, pink on here, but I felt like it may be a bit overkill. So I went with like pink accents down here on the black lines like we saw. I thought about doing pink shoes, maybe like pink shoes underneath here, maybe the chrome shoes that Edge wore or something to try and tie it in. I didn't draw my tattoos and hair again because I didn't want to go through that, but you guys get the gist. It's going to have the MDT Live going down the side. You got the MDT Live butt logo, MDT logo on the knee pad. You get some cool pink and silverish kick pads going on and the sleeve and everything. So I kind of want to keep that same like look for the attire, just change it up a little bit, you know, get a few different logos and stuff. I'll probably do a Vindication gear. You know, some of my favorite things, I'll probably make gear like that. And even if I don't completely wrestle in these gears, I just want them made because I think they'd be pretty cool and maybe I could plug them in at any moment. You never know. You never know what the future holds for Trey White in the pick fed or whatever the hell the case is. But I think that's pretty much what I wanted to cover today, man. I wanted to showcase this car. I also wanted to show you that new attire right there and showcase the Eddie Guerrero in the car because it looks pretty freaking epic. I love this. So stick Eddie Guerrero down in here. There. Not there, there. But before we get out of here, guys, let's get into our random shout-out. And this shout-out is going to go to Luffy D. Yami, who says, this just crossed the line in the best way possible, talking about the MDT stage animation graphics. If you guys appreciated that, definitely go check that out. That was a lot. That was very cool. Wrestlistic made that for me, which I thought was absolutely excellent. I wanted to upload it to you guys so you guys could use it. Like, if you have a computer screen or something like that that you guys use for your arenas, and, you know, you wanted to make a custom MDT or you just wanted to play that in your arena or do do something creative and cool with it. I wanted to put that up to you guys so you guys could use it with the Cross the Line intro theme for you there. But that pretty much does it for today's video, guys. Let me know what you think of the cruiser here or the lowrider car for the, for everything that you could use that for. What do you think of the new MDT attire? Do you guys like that one more? You like the pink one or the MDT live gear better? Let me know down in the comment section below. But a huge shout out to Luffy for that. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to the channel, and I think we have a new ranking video going up tomorrow, which should be pretty damn good. And I think I'm aiming for next weekend for Vindication to drop, so stay freaking tuned. It's going to be absolutely insanity. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Don't cross the line like Dolph Ziggler did. You crossed the line.